man, the temperature dropped like 30 degrees overnight. Shit is crazy. What up, blockheads?
It's funny, like coming up to lights now, well, especially in colder climate, like in colder weather, my regular main visor doesn't fog up, but the sun visor that's built into the helmet fogs up. Oh, hey guys, you want to buy some carpets?
So I've got no real route plan today, but I do want to get off the bike here at some point and show you guys a little change that I did make to the bike. Nothing too major, but it does affect the ride quality a bit, taking a little bit of getting used to. You know what, I'll see if I can pull over up here at this parking garage. Go up on the top. There's also a couple of things that I want to go over in this episode, installment, video, motovlog, whatever the hell you call it. A couple of y'all's follow-ups, feedback regarding the bobber, or the idea of a bobber project, and also following up regarding auto-tune, because a lot of people are posting up like, oh, there's no reason to run auto-tune, just use one of their canned maps. Well, so the reason I ran auto-tune, just for those of you guys that are telling me to just run one of their canned maps and that they're fine, whenever I first got the exhaust, I ordered the FP3 with it as well, from Vans and Hines, and I've been running a canned map for a long time. Actually, I ran a canned map originally, and the canned map, it works great, but the reason I ran auto-tune is because with the canned map, I'm averaging like 35 miles per gallon, which is pretty damn low compared to what you're supposed to get stock, right? So stock, from the Iron 883, you're supposed to get like over 50. Like 50-ish. Woo! Weightlessness there for a second. Oh, what's up, Hogwarts? Shit. This parking lot is empty. It's awesome. So yeah, the reason I was running auto-tune was basically so I was trying to get a better tune so I could get better miles per gallon. Like y'all were saying, there's nothing wrong with the stock map or the canned map, but I wanted better MPGs, so I tried it out. Unfortunately, it did not work out. So, recent addition. Man, it's kind of chilly. I know you guys up in the Great White North are going to say it's not, but yeah, for me it is. Uh-oh, we got security. Security! So yeah, alright, what do you guys notice different about the bike since last time around? I threw a new seat on it. So I was asking you guys recently your feedback on seats. I was talking about... I was talking about going with the Springer seat. I think you guys talked me down from a Springer seat. A couple of reasons. If I had gone Springer seat, I would have kept the stock suspension or gone with a different coilover. And then also added a Springer seat in addition, which a lot of you guys might disagree with, you know, when I was talking about going the bobber route. But you guys brought up a lot of really awesome points regarding, you know, going a bobber, chopping the fender, doing away with the belt guard. So it's definitely one of those things like of opinion. If I were to do a bobber, you know, obviously you want to chop the fender and all that stuff, so it's actually a bobber. But yeah, I think I would get a different fender. Although whenever I changed over to the seat, which is a Harley 48 seat, looking under my last one, I kind of realized that the last one kind of damaged the paint on my fender a little bit, which I didn't really realize beforehand. So if you guys see this little area right here, I had read about that and about people's stock seats damaging the fender, but you know, I didn't realize mine was that bad until I actually, like, I've had the seat off before, but I've never really like actually sat and looked at the fender, usually just because I've got, I don't know, my priority is elsewhere, like relocating the gauge or something like that. But yeah, man, that's kind of bad, huh? I don't know. Maybe I'll get it wrapped or something, because I mean, it looks pretty gnarly. Anyway, swapping over to this seat, riding it, it's definitely a lot different than the stock seat. So you're not... Fucking security. Get out of here, security. Are they gone? They're gone. I don't even know where I left off. I was just so distracted by security there because I felt like they were gonna, you know, come over and try and talk to me or say, tell me to leave. I'm not doing anything, man. I'm looking at the bike on top of the freaking parking garage. Get off my So anyways, yeah, I changed out the seat. Funny process, I was actually calling Harley. I was pretty confident that the Harley 48 seats were directly interchangeable with the Iron 883 seats. And so I called him up and I was basically like, hey, I'm looking to put a smaller seat on my bike, and I like the 48 seats. And so I asked him, I'm like, the 48 seats are directly interchangeable with the Iron 883 seats, right? And the guys are like, oh, I think you have to like do one little mod or something like that. And he put me on hold to check. And so whenever he checked, he said, actually, you don't have to really do any mod. He's like, they're directly interchangeable. You just gotta take the other one off, put the new one on. And instead of it bolting on right here, it bolts on right here. So this little plastic plug was originally in this spot. So I remove that, put this new little screw holder, the little bolt holder, plus the little plastic bracket that goes over it. I don't know what the name for it is, but relocated that one right there, put the plug there, and then I've got this little extra for the pillion for that fits the stock seat. But so he came back on the phone and he said that they had a pull-off 48 seat if I wanted to come up and check it out. Came up, checked it out. He said he would give me a really good deal on it. I was like, yeah, why not? Because I was looking at the Biltwell Sporty 8 seats, or, oh man, I forget the name of them, the LePera Bare Bones. And so I like the LePera Bare Bones. The reason I was like kind of leaning away from the Biltwell is because like I like the stitching and I wanted to get one with stitching, but the stitching on those was really light. And so, you know, me being picky AF, I was kind of leaning away from lighter stitching just because I wanted to keep the seat darker. So, but the Biltwell Sporty 8s look pretty much identical to the damn stock 48 seats. You know, profile wise, they're pretty darn similar. So I ended up going just basically going up there, checking this one out as like a temporary, and they gave me an awesome deal on it because it's a used seat. You know, I mean, you can't really see that there's any imperfections in it, but there's like little tiny stuff that they were like, yeah, we'll knock off a hell of a lot. And they did. So I figured, get that seat. Why not try it out? I still think, because of like the kind of the ride quality, like just riding over here, that I'm still interested in looking at the LePeras, because the LePeras do like sit a little bit lower and the backs of them come up a little bit and they've got like this little ridge. Because when you're riding this one and you go, you tend to slide off the back of it. We'll see. It definitely makes you sit differently on the bike. I feel like I have to sit much closer now. And so like instead of my hands being like out here, they're a little more, you know, crunched up just for reference, you know, sit on the bike real quick. So like this is where I'm sitting now versus normally I'd be like back here with my arms straight out. That's like the perfect length. But right now my ass is sitting like right here. Like my butt is like here. And so the seat's like in the middle. So I'm like, it's like halfway on, halfway off. And so then if I go, it slides back. So I don't know. I really wish I could sit on the LePera seat before buying it. But LePera makes a diamond stitch seat, which looks pretty badass. But on their website, it's only for the 48. So if you guys haven't gotten the point, I don't think I'm going to go with the Springer seat anymore, just because of a lot of the stuff that you guys brought up. You know, if I'm sticking with the stock suspension, no real reason, I guess. So anyways, yeah, that's where she sits as of right now. This will fix itself, but it's been happening more and more lately. GoPro. See, file repaired. It does this all the time, yo. Alright, so I guess we're good for now. Fucking A. SD error problems. Man, my GoPro's been doing that a lot more lately. It's been giving me these like error messages. The SD cards are fine, but it keeps saying SD error. Pissing me off. Damn it. So anyways, that's the update on the bike and some thought process into, I guess, the direction that I'm going with it. I am still entertaining the idea of the fender, but I think I'll do like a different fender, not the stock fender. Although the stock fender is kind of marred up, so I mean, what do you guys think about that? Should I just get the rear fender like repainted? That's going to be a pain in the ass and cost money. If I were to chop it, I could chop it shorter than that part of the rear fender. Security. Decisions. Chop the stock rear fender because it's marred up. I'd have to chop it like hella short though. I don't know, we'll see. I'm not really gonna push my luck too much with this SD card, yo. Or with this SD. It's not even the SD card, man. It's a freaking GoPro giving me error messages. I'll just go for a quick loop, see if the battery lasts, because it said 2 bars, but now it dropped down to 1 after all that bullshit. Oh man, the bike is running so much nicer using a can mat, plus it's kind of cold outside, so you guys know how vehicles run in colder weather. I love it. Oh shit, nice car, bro. What's up? So anyways,
thank you guys for all of your crazy amounts of comments and input. Really helped me out. You know, I think y'all have convinced me to kind of go the direction of like more of a solid seat instead of a Springer seat. So I'm researching those options at the moment. I wouldn't say researching those options. I've pulled the trigger on a smaller 48 seat, which isn't so bad. I do kind of like how you can see the spline in the back part of the gas tank.
Right, yeah.
Yeah, I don't know. I think I'm still going to be looking into the LePera Bare Bones Diamond Stitch. And if it fits the 48, it should fit the 883. But we'll see. I'll call them up on Monday. Speed humps. You guys also had a lot to say about the rear fender. I think one of the funniest ones, and this is something that I was considering before. It was very direct and to the point. I forget the user that posted it, but, you know, props, made me laugh. It said, chop fender, wet ass. Which is true, and especially like here in Florida, I mean, during the summer it rains pretty much every single day. You can set your watch by it almost, you know, afternoon showers. So I think that's a big consideration. Like if I were considering going with a shorter chopped fender, I think I would want to keep the stock one. But we'll see. Direction I do know I'm going. Currently I have drag bars at home. They're a set of zero drags. I want to say 4.5 inches of pullback. And I've got some new grips as well, so that's a future incoming how-to video, so you guys look out for that. Fucking Raptor. It is a Raptor. Woo! Damn, the bike runs so much better now. It's ridiculous without the damn auto-tune, plus it being colder. It's night and day difference. So yeah, another little update. I've also been working on some graphics for t-shirts, so you guys should be seeing those coming up pretty soon. Actually, I'll try to post them up here, do some mock-ups real quick. So I've got this design in the pipeline, as well as this one. And this one. If you guys have any input or any ideas on shirts that you would want from the Blockhead Company, you guys let me know. Post up in the comments below. But yeah, I should have those, I don't know, ready by like a week or so from now. What's up, Sheriff? Oh man, I just smelled hamburgers. Oh, it smelled so good. Somebody's grilling out. It's kind of cold weather to be grilling out though, man. Okay, so for us, like us Floridians, like I said, cold weather is like 50 degrees. So currently it's like 40 something degrees, which means we're cold. So meh. So yeah, like yesterday it rained like crazy. And because it was shitty weather, it was Saturday yesterday. Because it was shitty weather, I was like, you know what? I'm gonna go ahead and film a moto vlogger, my moto vlogger setup. So basically, you know, set up the camera inside, and I was, you know, since it was raining outside, figured do an inside recording. I've had lots of requests for you guys asking me to do a video on what my moto vlogger setup is because of the quality and all that stuff. So I recorded, you know, a nice little 20 minutes of going over my helmet and like how I run my mic and all that good stuff. And unfortunately, I cannot use the video because it is bad. It just didn't turn out how I wanted it to. The quality was okay, but yeah, I definitely need to, I'll get it figured out. Damn, yo, like I'm speeding and you're hauling ass. So anyways, I'm actually getting kind of low on battery, so I'm gonna leave y'all off with that. Once again, thank you guys for all your input and your feedback whenever I posted up, you know, that I was considering going the bobber route. I still think I might, but like I said, I'm gonna look into some aftermarket fender options. I don't know, I'm really kind of stuck there because the stock fender is a little marred up at the moment, so we'll see. But yeah, I think I'm staying away from Springer seats, so hopefully next video I should be riding up to do... to do drag bars. We'll see. Man, I am frozen. Oh, for real, dude. Go. Hey, can't believe I had to stop for your right turn. It was totally open. So anyways, I hope you guys are staying warm out there, depending on where you're at. I know in Australia, y'all are nice and warm because it's opposite seasons. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this little overview video. No real, like a super solid message to it. Just going over y'all's previous feedback. And just so you guys know, I really do appreciate all y'all's feedback. I go through, I read it all. Regarding that as well, you know, I try to respond to all the comments, but yo, you guys are getting crazy with the comments. So if I don't respond, don't take it personally. Like I said, I always do try to get to them, but sometimes, man, if I go a couple days, like, it is getting overwhelming. So I think that's going to have to be something that I address here. So I guess I'm addressing it in that.
Oh, man, I'm frozen. All you northerners are calling me a little bitch. You're right. I am a little bitch. I live in Florida.
So yeah, if you guys enjoyed the video, go ahead and hit that like button down there. If you guys aren't subscribed, go ahead and hit that subscribe button as well, either here in the bottom right of the video, or in that little area, or at the end of the video. Until I catch you guys next time, y'all ride safe, stay vigilant, and I will catch y'all later. Deuces!